Mike, you gotta tell me, like, where are we?
This is Flo's Diner. Downtown Wilson, North Carolina. It's been here since the 1958, 52, but all of my life, of course. And grew up with this biscuit before every baseball game. And you can't eat one every day because it would be unhealthy, but it sure is good because I come every time I come to Wilson, I have one.
Like right when you get your driver's license, first place you head to?
Yeah. Well, I went to the DMV and then came straight to the drive-thru.
Wow, well, when that was a guess out of the blue and it became reality.
So this is really quintessentially Eastern North Carolina fried pork tenderloin with hoop cheese on a lard biscuit. And you don't really, you know, this is chicken fried, of course, and flour, seasoned dredge probably. But with hot sauce, it's a real distinctly peculiar flavor that's memorable, you know. And as savory as a biscuit can get, you put fried pork in it, you know. What was here? Was there anything here?
It was a service station. This place is over 100 years old. And it was 5 points at the time.
Which, 5 points, and it was still busy, but yeah. It was thriving. There was
business. It was thriving back in the day. And they had grocery stores here and a library over here and all this stuff. And see, when Mother and I came, there wasn't anything here except for Grae's right over here. Mama made cathead biscuits, cheese biscuits. We had the best tenderloin and ham and sausage you could ever put in your mouth. And we do French toast, good old Southern, just pancakes and good stuff.
Yeah. You know. And the biscuit recipe, I mean, that seems
that's
to be
mother's.
The lard is unique in that biscuit. Yes. Because it makes it almost like, in some ways, like a biscuit, but also a sandwich. And it holds together. It's not a crumbly biscuit.
No. Yeah. Well, yeah. You just ate one. It was good,
it was delicious. And it held together.
And it will hold together.
Yeah.
Our biscuits have always been that way. Mm-hmm. And that makes it real special.
Yep.
Because everybody can't make a biscuit anymore.
That's right.
And once that legacy's gone, I don't know what we're going to do.
It's got to be passed on. Yeah. It's a story that has to be told, and yeah. It's a recipe that has to be, you know.
Well, see, Mama's taught. She taught 7 or 8 people how to make biscuits.
Yeah.
And they were young, and they've stayed. And most of them, anytime I meet a biscuit maker, I can get on the phone and call somebody because I know she taught them how.
Right.
And the legacy lives on.
Yeah.
And we taught a lot of ladies how to make our kind of biscuits.
Right.
And that's what makes Flo's Kitchen is the biscuits. Mm-hmm. And all of the girls here. All the Southern ladies here.
And there's no male employees here. This is a woman's business, right?
This is a woman's business.
Well, what happens to Flo's diner? Who's the next generation?
Well, probably my niece will be the one that...
She works here with you?
Yeah, she's back there.
Okay.
I don't know if you can see her or not.
I see her.
But she, when I was 6, she took over, and I have a daughter, too, but she teaches special ed children, so she's really not that interested, but she said, Mother, I would come home before I let Flo's, my grandma. She loved my grandmama. Her grandma went to Flo's. She said, I'd come home and run Flo's and let my teaching go as bad as I hate to before I'd see it go down.
It's sacred. It's a heritage.
Yeah. And it really, really is. I mean, honestly, it's from person to person.
Yeah. Well, it's good that you have it to pass on to another generation in the family.
And she's been with me 20 years, so she knows the business. She knows the business.
Your mother was always a cook. In the family.
My mother worked at the shirt factory for many years when I was growing up.
So what possessed her to open a restaurant?
Well, because she knew how to cook. No, she didn't. I possessed her to open up this restaurant because I wanted her to get out from cooking with everybody else. Well, Mother can make the best biscuit in the world, and people knew that.
Right.
Because people loved her, and she knew everybody. And she went to work at the country restaurant out on 58. Yeah. Boy, that's when Click knew come on it.
Okay.
Mother made biscuits out there for years.
So that's where I had Flo's biscuits for the first time. Because before baseball practice or a baseball game on a Saturday morning,
we would
go to the country restaurant, and I played for New Hope.
Mm-hmm.
And then my dad, we would go to the country restaurant, and we'd get bags of tenderloin and cheese biscuits.
Exactly.
And then we would eat it, and that would be fuel for the baseball game.
I know.
Right there in New Hope, the old New Hope Elementary School.
Old New Hope, I know exactly.
So that's where my memory of it began, and you know, and here it is. You know,
here it is.
That's great.
It's been here a long time, and she was very well liked and very well known, and that made our business easy.
Right.
I mean, it made it easy to grow because word of mouth.
Word of mouth, and you don't need marketing because you know everybody in the city and county.
Just about. And she would say, everybody would say, go to Flo's, Miss Flo's right there, you gotta go to Flo's, right. You gotta get a biscuit, you know, and that helped them just tremendously.
About soup.